that. It's like, oh, it just hasn't been. Like, the lawyers haven't cleared
wait,
it.
Put on your helmet.
Like 12 or 14 or something. But
it looks good. It's nice and visible. And you have hair to protect your head. Daddy has to wear the hat with the thick braid.
Younger than a certain age, you are required to wear a helmet.
Yeah.
Legally.
You want to close the garage door?
It's fine. Well, I can close it.
Jack, so, hey, Coco. You going for a walk?
Who's scared the dog is going to bite me?
I think it's a pretty nice dog. I don't think you need to worry.
We're gonna go start going uphill, be better, yeah.
You wanna go this way?
Okay.
Okay.
Come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on. Get armored up because these dogs pull me over, you know. Yeah, it's a lot more stable. Looks like kind of a basic kind of a bike.
Well, it's what they call like a hybrid, so it's like an upright kind of shaped like a mountain bike, but with road tires.
Oh.
So it's pretty adorable riding around.
I got this contour seat. You see how big it is?
Oh, yeah.
With a gel cushion.
Sure.
Because, you know, if you notice that tractor drivers have this, they use this kind of a contour seat because they have to, they can sit all day, you know?
Let's keep right. Yeah, we're moving over. That's right. He's dissatisfied.
Coco. Hey, don't go too fast. Don't go too fast. Lagging, I don't know why she can. She'll go fast if we're going towards where there's a cat located, you know? Tell Alec not to go too fast. She's got to poop now. Come on. Get it on the way back. The poop. Are we coming back this way?
Yep. They do it at Vernon Street Square, and they do like free bike fittings and tune-ups.
The 28th, is that Earth Day?
You know, I have it on my phone.
Okay.
I'll have to double check what day it is, but it's in April. And yeah, it's kind of fun, and they'll tune your bike up, and they have like cool like vendors and information on cycling.
A phone holder like this.
Yeah, well, I have one. I just haven't gotten around to installing it.
Got a pretty big heavy phone.
What kind of phone do you have?
Like a Note, yeah, or something like that.
Oh. I want to get a folding phone if they come out with an Apple iPhone folder. Some McMansions, huh?
Yeah. Well, we're just gonna turn around. We're just biking around.
I can't go sideways, or I can't go up.
Yeah.
I can jump first.
Come on, come on, come on. Got a McMansion, huh?
taken, and I'm just gonna circle here.
Come on.
Hey, sorry.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
About 1:30, head back. Alec, no, where are you going? No, go this way, on that trail. I know what you're talking about, but Grandpa and Danny can't do that, and I don't have my mountain bike either, so.
I can go on that trail.
Well, Danny's got kind of a road bike, so
yeah.
It's not there.
Can I shoot up this
trail? Yeah, go ahead. Why don't you, Dad, would you go with him?
Wait, I don't know.
It doesn't go very far.
What are you going to do?
I'm just going to hang out here.
Sure you want to go this way? You know where you're going? Maybe we can take the street back. Let's go back on the street. Alec! This way. Come on back. They went that way. Oh, come on. I don't want to take that dirt road again. Come on back. Come on. Come on. They went, they're over here. Come on. They decided to follow us. They come on. Let's go back. Let's go back and meet them at the end of the trail. They're over there. Come on. Well, you can go pretty fast, huh? Here, Coco. Coco.
Here comes another car. Actually, you're probably a good person to ask about price.
This is from Canada. It's called a Trivel, T-R-I. And they merged with this Velco company, something, I don't know. So it's now it's Trivel.
How much did you spend on it?
Well, I got it used for $800, but they're normally about $4,000. And offer up,
okay.
But
yeah, this is a popular makeout spot for teenagers.
But I had to have the rear axle redone and
okay, I needed some work.
Well, after it went for a while. Well, after a few hundred miles, I got it like it was only 60 miles on it.
Okay.
And now it has 118? No, it's got to have more than that. Oh, well. I think the odometer got reset somehow.
What did you do for, like, sizing? Because I imagine size to you the same way you would for a bike.
Oh, I don't know. The seat adjusts back and forth.
Oh, okay. Well, that helps a lot, yeah. Okay, so if you get one with an adjustable seat, it's not so big a deal.
Yeah, this is...
The frame is not, like, really out of whack for your size.
This is... this company specializes in helping people with disabilities. So it's got... It's very ergonomic.
We can go for, like, 5-10 minutes. Come on, Alec.
I think it's a lot more ergonomic the way it's set up, you know. And I got the seat, I changed the seat, you know, to this contour seat. And I got 4 piston brakes for $500. There's 2 pistons on each side, you know, there's 4 piston brakes. Do I have time to fly my drone?
Yeah, you gotta leave in like 10 minutes, but yeah.
You gotta get to your meeting, I know.
Yeah.
you been here before?
This part? I think we've came here together.
Yeah, they have a really nice...
We rode back through this way the other way.
In the summer, that's another like, spray ground. They're like...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Cool. So you guys have kiddos. You spring roll here. And sure. Spray ground. It'd be a lot of fun.
Yeah,
it's
fun.
Yeah, you know, it's funny because they built the first half of this park in like 2000, 2008, and then the crash happened. And then the second half of the park literally was like a decade. Mm. It sat there
because
of financial crisis and this and that. And they finally built it.
Yeah.
Like just in time for the pandemic so we could kind of use it. But I know Sylvia, one of Jackie's friends, Elise, she lives in the new park. She's like, oh, they really haven't done much with the park. And I said, it may take years.
Yeah.
You know, just catch up with the funding.
Sure.
This is my new drone. I crashed. I had one like this, a version one. Now I have version three. But I crashed the version one into the tree when Teddy the dog got loose around running around La Jolla, and
I see.
And I wasn't watching where I was flying the drone.
Yeah.
This one has a nice controller built in. You don't have to use a tablet.
Yeah.
Except that you can't get third-party software on it.
Oh, okay.
It's Android.
Right. It's not meant to be a general purpose tablet.
You can't get some software. It's kind of made for search and rescue. They sell these a lot to first responders, you know.
Cool.
Okay.
Oh, it's going for the lizard?
Yeah. Squirrels, lizards, kids.
Yep.
Go after everything. Where's your bike, Alec?
Do you want to bring it over here? It's easier if they're all together.
Thank you. That's Grandpa. How high can you go?
Yeah, Uncle Paul. How high does it go?
Well, you're only allowed to go 400 feet.
400 feet's allowed. Okay. Yeah.
After that, you can run into helicopters and stuff.
Yeah.
Well, it's all regulated. You can go lower in the distance, so you gotta watch out.
Oh, you can't go lower than that?
Helicopters can go lower.
Oh,
but
okay.
Not planes.
I see.
Yeah, can you imagine an airplane lower than 400 feet?
Pretty dangerous.
Yeah.
Maybe a biplane. I don't know.
You're over where they take off and land. I mean,
yeah.
You don't realize how big and powerful and fast they are until
yeah.
They're like up close. Because up further away, they don't look like they're, you know,
yeah.
Not as dramatic.
Sure. Man, that's a big deal. One of those barreling down your way.
Yeah. The year the Boeing CEO had to resign.
Oh yeah. Yeah, I know there's a lot of stuff. I keep seeing more and more like news reports of like Boeing problems.
Yeah. Like scary stuff, dude.
Yeah.
Like wheels falling off, doors,
yeah.
Onboard fires forcing emergency landings.
Yeah, I should double check when I'm gonna fly as a Boeing.
Yeah. Book your flight, should that be part of the disclosure?
Right.
Just so you know, this is a Boeing flight, Boeing airplane, we think it's safe.
It passed their security checks, you know.
This is a big problem with Boeing, it's a duopoly.
Yeah,
the
Airbus.
The only ones who make commercial airliners. You know, a lot of people who make military airliners or personal, you know, what do you call those, private jets? But so it's like, what are you going to do? Like, and Airbus is already over capacity. They can't fill the orders they have. It's very hard to tool up and build something. But, that's kind of the sad thing when you have, like, some duopoly. And usually there's more accidents on those things. You hear about accidents on those private airplanes.